Like Diana Ross, you were there, and now again, you are here. I'm crazy about you.
And I got an opportunity 10 years ago to introduce to you a talent, my baby. We did a movie together, and since then, I mean, he's just had blockbuster success with his album Off the Wall. Ladies and gentlemen, my baby, Michael Jackson.
This film with Sidney Lumet, of course, Michael Jackson was not very well known in Europe, and now it's a fabulous star. How did you explain the extraordinary success of Michael Jackson around the world? Comment vous expliquez le succès incroyable de Jackson depuis?
Well, to me, Michael is brilliant, and he's just as a little boy growing into his talent.
Voilà, il a grandi brillant, il l'est resté, il a commencé avec les Jackson 5, il a grandi sur scène, comme beaucoup de showman américains.
If he's grown from where starting to being a big success now, where will he be, you know, in the future?
Oui, alors s'il est une star maintenant, qu'est-ce que ça va être quand il sera encore plus grand? Mais c'est vraiment quelque chose d'incroyable.
Dinah Ross. Yeah. Very dear friend, Dinah Ross. She's the kind of person I can tell her anything, the most private of secrets, and she tell me.
Line two. Good morning, two.
Hello.
Hello there. Let's put a name to you. What's your name?
Naran Joseph.
Naran, off you go with your question.
Where did you first meet Michael Jackson?
He was a very young boy. He was with the Jackson Five then, and they had been singing in their hometown called Gary, Indiana. And their father wanted them to make a record with Motown. And they were brought to Detroit, where I was living at the time, Detroit, Michigan. And that's when I saw them. And they were five boys, and they had little green outfits and little hats on. And that was when everybody recognized that Michael had a very special talent. And then slowly but surely, he went out on his own.
And you've remained friends all the way through?
Yes, we've remained friends over the years. I just don't see him half as much as I used to when he was younger. Now I live on the West Coast, on the East Coast of America, and then I travel to Europe a lot, and he lives on the West Coast, so we kind of miss each other a lot. But we do talk, and he has met my children, my boys.
We had Macaulay Culkin in a couple of weeks ago, who obviously is publicly friends with Michael Jackson as well. We were talking there about when your friends appear in the newspapers and your reaction. How about you?
Yeah. Well, you know, I think he's always been very shy and misunderstood a lot because he can't do the ordinary things like we can do. I can go to the markets and I can go shopping and I can drive my car. And Michael being so very popular that a lot of times he's not able to really get out into the public. So he's misunderstood about certain things. And I do think that his lifestyle has, you know, made it very difficult for him to have a lot of fun like his age group should have had, you know, a lot of good times with their friends and so on. But he's a very special, and he's a very special human being. And so he'll never be I don't think he'll ever be ordinary. He's just really special. Stevie Wonder's also a special, special human being like that.
Okay, thanks for your question, Naran.
And next time you're talking to Michael, tell him, yes, he can come on the show if he really wants to, because he keeps asking.
You know, I'm sure he would love to. I am absolutely positive, because he loves young people. He always has kids around him. And now he's bought a home away, but he's always keeping kids there. And they all come on tours, and he's there with kids all the time. His house, in one room of his house, he's got almost every toy that they've ever made for kids. And it's really not for him as much as for his guests to come and visit him.
So next time you speak to him, tell him that there's a show in Britain you're just going to love.
It's a long relationship with Michael Jackson. Back when he was a young recording star, there are rumors that he changed his looks to look like you. How would you describe Michael Jackson - Diana Ross? What is that?
Well, you see,
We actually love each other. He's like one of my children. When he started his career, I introduced them on their very first television show, which was the Ed Sullivan Show. And then I had my own television special at that time, and I introduced them, the Jackson 5, on the television special. And I took a special interest in him, and we were very close. When the boys came from Indiana, they stayed with me in my house in California, and I was like their house mother or something, and I kind of took care of them until their parents came. So we just built a relationship in the early days, and then he went on to have his own career, of which he's very, very talented, and he became so very, very successful, just like skyrocketed, the whole family, actually.
Mm-hmm. Are you close now?
Not as close now. I don't get to see him very much, and that's because, again, my life has just gone in a different direction. I live in Europe a lot of the time with my husband, and so it's just that we don't see each other half as much as I would like to see him. I did see him maybe a couple months ago and introduced him to my sons, my boys, and my little one, Evan, loves music and wants to look like Michael Jackson.
Do you think he wants to look like you? Do you buy that? Do you think
No, I don't buy that at all.
We touched briefly. I know that you've recorded or re-recorded the cover version of Michael Jackson's song. What particularly prompted you to choose that one?
It's just such a beautiful song, and I really, I have a girlfriend in California, one of my dearest friends, and we just found that she has cancer. And I spent many days with her in the hospital, and I sort of wanted her to know that she wasn't alone. It's really hard to talk about, but I think, you know, we all have these things that happen in our lives, and I sort of wanted, I want her to know, and I want, you know, people to know that during the time that they're really not alone when there's difficulties. It's a beautiful song. It was well written. I don't think Michael wrote the song. He performs it beautifully. If I can just come up to the level of his performance of the song, it's amazing. And it just says all the things that, it just stayed in my mind all through the summer, this summer, August, September. The song just wouldn't leave me. And I decided that, I asked EMI, I said, would you mind me covering this song? And they said, we think it's a great song too. Mm-hmm. And so I went into the studio and recorded it.
Has that song at all helped you? Because you've also had a tough year, haven't you? You lost your brother
this
year.
Yes, it is. But also for other families, you know, we're losing a lot of talented young people to AIDS. And I've always tried to do songs that are inspirational and that can help people through difficult times and also bring some happiness to them, you know, and I hope my music does that. So yes, you know, we all, you know, we'll have losses in our lives, and we'll have, you know, I lost my mother. This song makes me think of her. And even though it's been quite some time since I lost her, she's always still with me. And you want people to know that, you know, that a family should stay together. And, you know, I find it really hard if a man doesn't like his mother, you know, for instance. You know, I want men to love their mothers. And, you know, I have a strong feeling about people knowing the ones that they love and in the ones you love, like the song.
Have you spoken to Michael about recording it as well?
I wasn't able to find him. You know, people think that I see him all the time. He's been traveling on tour. I tried to send some messages out, you know, to let him know that I was recording it, and also to, you know, also to congratulate him. You know, he's a father and a new husband. I wasn't able to reach him. I have not seen Michael for more than a year. And because of the early days, people think that I know him and that we're together all the time. And it's not. Our lives have really gone in different ways. And even though I feel very close to him, like a lot of times you don't see all your friends, but still you know that they're your friends. It's just like you can be apart for many years, but then when you come back together, it's like yesterday. No, but I haven't seen him. I haven't talked to him. I see people in the street of New York, and they say, hey, tell Michael Jackson I said hello. And I went like, I don't see Michael.
Do you think he's going to enjoy fatherhood?
Yes, because I think he loves children. He really, truly does. You know, it's been very difficult for him. But he really, you know, he's still a child. You know, he's still a child at heart. Very
part
much
of
so.
My family. Yes.
We have a lot of the same bone structure and a lot of skin color.
Well, Michael does now because he's had it all done.
you take that as a compliment?
You cannot. I refuse you to insult Michael. He's a friend of mine. Yeah. I love him. Yeah. And I don't like people making fun of him.
No, no, but we
are... Okay, Clive, c'est le moment de la fermer.
I get real serious when I talk about Michael. No. And I think we should really kind of look at his life with compassion. He makes incredibly good... I want to say the bad word. Good music.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, the world's most fabulous group, the Jackson Five.
Chance to talk about, I wanted to talk about how we met and all of that. The boys came to Detroit for a showcase for Berry Gordy, and I remember them wearing these little green outfits and these hats, and they did a show in Berry's house in Detroit called the Pool House, and we knew then that it was going to be something special. And I got an opportunity to introduce them on the Ed Sullivan Show, and the rest is just history. We did a television special and so on, and I played with Michael. And they came to live with me in California for, it seemed like just a few months, but I don't know how long it was there, when their parents were moving from Indiana up to California. And I got to know them very well, and I tried to train them. I tried to tell them. Tried to teach them how to make their beds and how to wash the dishes and pick up the dishes from the table. So I was sort of like a parent, and I feel like that. Since the beginning of their careers, I feel very much as if they are my children. Even though I don't see them as often, Michael and I bonded very early. And so I feel like I am a parent of these boys, and I'm a grandparent of their children. I'm happy they're standing behind me. I know that they have a lot to say. And Michael, I don't see these guys that much. I'm so happy to look back and see their faces. Anyway, so congratulations, and I'll give you your welcome to the Hall of Fame. Jemaine? Tito? Jackie? And Marlon?
A supreme singer returns, but has the record industry forgotten Diana Ross? In our exclusive interview, Diana finally opens up about her DUI nightmare and her friend, Michael Jackson.
I know that you're friends with Michael Jackson. How do you think the media has treated him?
Please, I can't go there.
No.
But, I just think, it's such a painful subject. It's just so hard.
That's as much as Diana Ross has ever said publicly about the troubles of her longtime friend, Michael Jackson, her co-star in the 1978 film The Wiz, who the tabloids claimed had work done to look like her.
Can't do anything that, is not scrutinized, overly scrutinized. Don't you agree? Okay, I understand.
She is far more open about her own brush with the law when she was arrested last year in Arizona for DUI.
Was that a wake-up call to you?
Maybe.
What do you feel like you learned?
A choice you made could change your life. Things could change your life just like that. You're on top one moment, you're not on top.
Right now, Diana is on top, hitting the road for a short U.S. tour that kicked off at Caesar's Palace in Atlantic City. A mix of more obscure songs and old Supremes hits. Diana delivers a sexy two-hour show, amazing when you consider this.
You turned 60 this year.
Hey, girl.
know, I never really think about age. Today, aging is not, you know, like a bad thing.
Except that despite a five-decade career that has spawned more than 50 albums and countless hits, Diana was dropped by her label.
I don't have a record contract.
Everyone's got a day to my own with not one Ross, but two, Diana and her daughter Tracy. So what was the highlight of today? And there had to be some classic moments.
I started crying when we were taking the pictures.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I love my mom. And we don't get this opportunity that often.
Essence Magazine provided the opportunity. Diana and daughter Tracy, who stars in the UPN sitcom Girlfriends, provided the oh-so-sexy, goofy, fun poses. Cameras began flashing at 1, but Diana began primping at 6 in the morning.
First thing I do is take care of my hair.
How many people do you have on hair detail?
Nobody. Yeah, me too. It's not a lot.
But you're Diana.
That's why it takes so long. It takes, you have to do it yourself.
The Essence cover shot and article, which hits newsstands April 20th, comes on the heels of Diana's DUI arrest in December 2002, an episode that neither mother nor daughter cared to discuss.
When your mom, this past year has been a year where you have to take on issues, have you been, you know, overly protective about that, and have, has that unsettled you?
Girlfriends is a great
show. It's a great show.
Let me try another, approach that I know you'll shut down, but that is what everyone in the world is talking about, you know, right now.
No way.
So to quote Kenny Rogers, you gotta know when to walk away.
Michael Jackson, like you, was a product of Motown, Detroit.
Yes.
Were you very close during the shoot?
We were very close during the shoot and even before. When Michael, the Jackson 5, came to Motown, I was there when they did their first audition. And Barry gave me an opportunity to introduce them on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Everybody knows that Michael Jackson has been profoundly influenced by you. Some say even physically. They do.
Well, they say that, but I don't think so.
Let me put it this way, man. If I had a choice, I'd like to look like you.
No!